as to how do we ramp up our advocacy role and developing ways to be able to encourage people to advocate for themselves and to be very thoughtful as to when we can do group advocacy.
Well, I rise to the challenge, basically, of saying it is gatherings like this that need to put a dent into that ongoing process, which is evolving into higher and higher rates of addictions and suicide and everything else.
It's time not to go with the flow. It's time, if we're going to do anything, we're going to be the current that fights against the flow.
And I think that a part of the crisis that we're facing requires that we really change the way we look at things, and that and these things are unacceptable. We talk about poverty. It's unacceptable that there be poverty.
So in the future, if we don't figure out how we can deal with our basic economic development to meet basic needs and that infrastructure that emerges from citizens working together in a democratic society, we're really, really at risk. We do what we do because we believe in equity and fairness. We want a legacy for the future. We're driven and based on compassion because we do care and we care about our fellow people. And we want a community of voices. If we can continue to be that as our foundation, we will move forward and for the next 50 years.
So, you know, it's a place where you go back home and, you know, every street, every corner, the line here. But I never had the pleasures of being part of the Tunnelin Coffee House. And Jeff, when he gave me a call to invite me, and for this special cause, the fundraiser for the center, really it was just thrilling. And to return here again to Kitchener, thank you for coming. And the entertainment's been so lovely.